Tool Review Tuesday. Roll the intro. As you can see my intro, I've done a lot of video reviews, but today marks the first video review of Tool Review Tuesday. So I'm very excited to have this brand new tool to unbox. This is by the Craig Company. It's called the AccuCut. And this is something that you hook your circular saw to. And this is what it does. Rip cuts, cross cuts, angle cuts. Oh, let's check out the back first before I tear this up. High performance guide track for straight and clean cuts. Cuts up to 48 inches, attaches easily to your saw, stays in place without clamps. Sawed aluminum track will not rust. 100% support through the cut. So this is what comes with it. A universal saw sled, two 26.5-inch aluminum guide tracks, a starting block, two track connector bars, track identification clip, detailed instruction manual. These are relatively heavy, so it feels like they will definitely sit. Oh yeah, it'll sit on your the weight will hold in place really nice because it's heavy. Yeah, and you can feel these strips right here. They're just a nice tacky grip. I just wiped this table down, so this isn't really going to be like a woodwork surface. But it feels like it definitely will grip. And I'm guessing these two arrows, that shows the connecting point. This is your saw sled. Okay, this looks like the connector parts that go between the two tracks. They slide in there, coupling. And this is your, yeah, so this looks like this goes in the end, so that kind of helps get your saw straight on the right path. So I do apologize, I feel like I'm yelling into the camera, but I am competing with the wind, and this is our weather right here that's on its way. So this is ready to be assembled. Let's take a closer look now and align the indicator arrows. Okay. Put those in halfway. The starter clip. I think I'm ready to get started. I have the track all set. So as you can see, it has this little tab that rests right up against the work that you're doing. I installed the sled, I believe it's called, on the end here. One thing I learned in the other video is the sled right here shims the saw off your work a little bit. So I adjusted the depth, I think, just enough right there. This is a 1/4 inch right here. And the one thing that I recommend doing is testing this out first on some scrap pieces. If you have a really expensive piece of, let's say, some sanded oak 3/4 inch plywood, and you're trying to make the exact cut for the first time, there might be a little bit getting used to this. That's just something I've learned working with tools. Let's mark this up to 1 foot. We'll test that out. So it's gonna be a 1x4 piece. The end here. Okay. Sometimes I put a little circle around it so you can just see the mark. So the clamps would help if you have some pieces of plywood where it's not supported all the way. So actually this is sagging a little bit right there. We'll just first test it out and see how it works without the clamps. And then just put this in your saw. I got a little red, there we go, the red line that lines it up. Okay, we go. All right. Well, it's a little bit over a foot. I think I'm gonna have to, I can do some micro adjustments on here to get this lined up perfectly on the guide. So I'll do that real quick and we'll do another 1 foot by 4 foot piece. Okay, we're gonna try the other end now. Okay. Give it a shot. Looks like it's on the money. Yes, all right. Get the tape measure out. See if I have 1 foot. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Okay, somehow the track may have walked a little bit, so I wasn't aware of that. So you could clamp it down. I may not have made sure before I started the saw that that end didn't walk as I was making my final adjustments. This time I made sure to do that and it turned out perfect. And the very end piece, you can see, it finishes very well. Nice straight cut all the way through the end. Sometimes cutting angles can be a little tricky. So when you're working on the gable end of a house, for instance, you need to cut straight angles. So let's see how it works doing something like this. All right, so on this end over here, I measured out 8 inches. On this end right here, I measured out 24 inches. So we're gonna see how it can handle an angle cut. I'm right at about the, I think I can continue following that out. On this end, the track is short about 1 inch. That end, it's over about 3/4 of an inch, but I think the saw will continue to guide all the way through. Let's see how it works. Now I noticed when I first put this down to start, that end lifted up. That may have been my problem the very first cut that I made. So I'm looking at the alignment and it's good to go. Beautiful. All right, see how that turned out? That cut right on the mark, 8 inches. That one right on 24. There, beautiful angle piece. So I definitely give this a thumbs up. As you can see, it passed my test with flying colors. If they offer this in a longer version or extensions, that would be something that really excite me, so you can rip an 8 foot piece all the way down. Every once in a while I'm working with some kind of paneling where I have to cut some long strips, and it's nice to be able to, it would be nice to be able to just add some extensions to this. And as you can see, it works out really well. So anyways, if you find this video interesting and informative, please give it a thumbs up and help support my channel. That's it, friends. Thanks for watching. See you next time. All right, if you like this video, I think you might like a few other videos over there to the right. So please click on those. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, hit that button down below. If you want to see what I'm up to throughout the week, please connect me on Twitter and Instagram. All right, friends, enjoy.